Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 4 on the Mysterious JG. I'm trying to see if I remember how to hail a cab. Oh, I enter as a cab passenger, but you have to call it to the side with L trigger first. So it is allowed to happen. I suppose I could have called Roman for a free cab, but cabs are not expensive.
Yes. Okay.
And he just lets me sit right in the front seat with him, so. You can skip at extra cost. But yeah, this is the thing they put in the game. You can ride around in a cab if this is what makes for a fun game experience for you.
Listen, me jefe, I'm the boss. I'm here teach.
But anyway, we will skip for extra fare. And see, like, I could never bring myself to do that in GTA 5 because it costs us 21 bucks, yeah. And that's with the extra money we spent by skipping. Oh, Brucey. Boating, yeah.
Power boating. I'm into that. Wait for me at your place for an hour.
Nice one, SB. See you then.
Okay, why? Yeah, power boating's not a thing we've ever done before, so.
You're getting carjacked.
It's all you, man. You just signed our death.
You signed our death warrant. Well, we've only got an hour to get there, so crap.
Remember this?
Now, the moment you've all been waiting for. America's next top hooker is Crystal.
Fuck. Alright, well, I can't figure out the correct way to get to,
And now a message from babies over.
Get onto the actual bridge. So this is gonna be a little bit more difficult than it should be. Okay, I mistimed that. But I don't want to keep Brucey waiting for our power boating trip. And if you're thinking, hey, JG, you said we'd get a chance to vote on what dates we wanted. I forgot that, like, he's got dates. I don't know if we get to do those with other people. Or if they're just unique Brucey dates. If he throws a date at me, like, somebody throws a date suggestion to me for, like, a little manly man play dates that I've never seen before. I might go for it just to, like, see it, if I don't remember what it was. Because he's definitely got the helicopter date that we can do with only with Brucey, I believe. And we can eventually unlock helicopter rides, although they're one of those things, like Roman's taxi rides, I don't know how useful they would be. Because I don't think you can ever do them during a mission. I think they would be, you know, maybe I'll make them useful. I mean, in a helicopter ride, once we've got the whole map unlocked, if we need to get home from a mission that's really far away from a safe house that I want to use? Sure. Ah, crap. Took that turn wrong. But I remember this place well enough from driving over and over and over to attempt that race with Brucey off screen to know that it doesn't really make that big of a difference which of these roads he used to get to. Alright, just don't tell me I'm late, Brucey, because, we literally ran someone over trying to get here on time. Hey, he's talking to the ladies. What the? It's a weird ass. Oh, he comes with ladies.
Move out, bro.
I did not realize that would happen. Yeah, I'd like to meet some new people. I mean, my last girlfriend turned out to be a cop. Like undercover cop, not like.
Okay, Nico, girl, let's live it up a little, yeah.
Wonder if I meant to pop the
Pier 45, Nikki. We ride in style.
So I have to actually pilot the boat, but okay. This would be pretty cool, though. But, Brucey, they can hear you, man.
They're smoking. We met up in the club and it was intense. Wasn't it, mate?
Yeah.
I was standing at the bar ordering a magnum, scoping the floor, you know, flexing my pants. And I saw these girls and I felt it. They saw what I was packing and they felt it too, didn't you?
Yeah, sure.
It wasn't the amount of money you were spending dragging you to Brucey. Was it, Landis?
Nah.
What are you talking about, man? These girls were as impressed with the body I was rocking as the bling I had on and the readies I was dropping. Alright? Get rid of the attitude. You're a winner too, bro.
We do give Brucey a lot of shit. He deserves it. But there is an element of why are we hanging out with him if we clearly hate him? Anyway, so I guess this date isn't that exciting after all, if it's just us leaving this place being drunk and being told to take Brucey home.
Me and Nicky are the tightest motherfuckers in the city. That's a fact. Who's back now, homie?
Okay, I guess this is just... Oh man, it's fairly fast. What if I can go boating with other people? Hey Jacob, you want to go boating? I mean, it could be good practice if you ever want to start carrying your drugs over the water. This isn't a game, like, Vice City sets it up a bit. San Andreas sets it up a bit. Again, it's like mostly for a handful of missions, but... I mean, this is the follow-up to GTA 3, where boating was not really well integrated. Like, New York City, you don't think about as a place where it's like, oh, let's go out and do some speedboating. I don't know the extent to which you're allowed to just go around, boating in city limits of New York. I really don't know.
Nicely done, Nikki. You are a winner, just like Brucey. Ain't that right, ladies?
Fancy truck. Alright, well, we had a quick Brucey date. Told you wouldn't have to deal with any more of those, but I guess I lied. You know what? Fuck it. While we're down here, pool show, strip club, guns, job, darts. Go play darts with Jacob, because we haven't done a date with Jacob. And darts is a date we haven't done at all. And
hey there, Jacob. You want to go play darts, man?
Sure, why not? Come get me at the next door.
Great. I'll head over to your place.
Yeah, why am I doing this? I don't know. While we're here on the island, you know, I want to see who has dialogue about what the hell happened with Michelle, too. But I haven't imagined that Jacob will just have dialogue concerning this in future missions, because, and, you know, Nico should feel bad about that. I feel bad about this. Nico should feel, Jacob got pulled into this shit. He had nothing to do with Michelle. Maybe the only reason Jacob isn't in jail right now is because Michelle feels like he and Nico are more useful to her employers on the outside. That's what's been hinted at, but... Yeah, like, it seems like the reason he's in this shit is because of Nico. He stuck his neck out to save Nico when Nico got in trouble with the Russians. He seems to like Nico. Nico's not really been all good news for Jacob. But, I mean, we are a good, solid customer for his guns. And at the end of the day, it's not all transactional. We're not all Donald Trump here. There can't be such a thing as friends who like each other. It can happen.
terms about undeniable links between major drug dealing rings and terrorist cells operating in the city. In the city that used to love to party and now lives in fear of everything. This warning is something not to be taken.
Let's go, Star.
All right, so where are these darts? They're fairly close. They are up here. And of course, you have to do a U-turn. We always have to do a freaking U-turn.
Okay, Sabato. Not here, too.
Why not?
He's gonna kill me up here.
What?
Fight for the end. Stop here.
Really?
I have a funny kind of artificial and the man with chemicals and produce with our chemicals coming with pesticides. Wrong. Man is wrong.
You'll stop smoking here.
Is this really, like, how you doing? Not terrible, but not great, you know? Yeah, I guess we are both being closely observed by the government, who are going to use us as some kind of cat's paws in their future operations. Or they'll send us to jail for long sentences. Our mutual acquaintance, who I guess you're kind of mad at, is Elizabeth. She's about to go to jail for a long time. But I guess your real problem is people are putting chemicals in the weed. Don't make fun of me, stop. JG doesn't know enough of my dialogue to make me talk right. To make me sound like a bumbleclot. Oh, hey, this is where we had that, I didn't realize this is the same place. This is the alley where we were shot a million times while trying to steal that car for Brucey. All right, so I can't bring myself to care whether we win at darts. I can a little bit with pool because I used to play pool. Darts, never played dart. I mean, I know the basic rules of darts, but never been my game. So when they got the game, the rules wrong with their pool game a couple of different points, it really got on my nerves. Oh, it's at the Irish pub. So of course, triple 20 is the best thing that you can hit, but you have to go out on a double or a triple, and you have to actually go down to zero, which means at the beginning you want to throw triple 20s to get your score low, and then eventually, I mean, unless you're a freaking robot and you hit triple 20 every time, eventually, yeah, you'll have a specific place you got to shoot for. Okay.
Yo, you stink, bitch.
So I got single 20. That was triple 20. So he's doing pretty much the same thing, shooting for triple 20 and not making it for the most part.
You bitch asshole.
Okay, so he got exactly 100 that time. Points. So I could win with double 20. Nope. All right. Oh, I thought I was at 20 for some stupid reason. Oops. I win. I actually did fairly well there.
Yeah, man. Well done, Nico. Can I take we
one? Thank you for playing one game of darts with me. We drove across the city for this. I mean, I wouldn't mind getting drunk, Jacob, but I guess you don't want to do that. I don't know how much time is left in the video. Actually, I should just check that now, because I kind of was like, eh, we just finished a plot thread. We have to continue the game a bit before anything else is going to happen. I was hoping to get some dialogue about the Michelle situation. Maybe Jacob will speak about it now. Who knows? But either we had generic stuff, date dialogue to work through that we didn't get through, or we haven't gotten to a place yet where anything's going to get talked about with that, other than Mallory going, "Oh, I can't believe she was a cop. I'm so sorry, Nako." That's all we're going to get. We don't get to go hang out with her. We go, you know, double dates. Me and Brucey could go out with Roman and Mallory. Instead, we go out with some chicks. It's like, it was really intense the way we met up, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you're not just talking about him because of his money, are you?
Nah.
Yo, good seeing you in our restaurant.
So basically, we're maintaining our friendships for purposes of awesome in-game bonuses. Jacob's is pretty awesome. Yeah, we got Roman up to full 100% after... oh, everybody loved... Well, Brucey's only got 74% like. Packy's only got 50% like and 50% respect. And if we knew who Packy was, that might mean something. But Jacob is at full 100. Roman's at full 100. They worship us as the gods themselves. But Brucey, we could improve our friendship with Brucey. As a matter of fact, we haven't even unlocked his ultimate superpower, helicopter race attack. For now, though, let us go to the safe house. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just really doing crazy shit that we've never done before here. Let's call for a free cab.
Roman, it's Nako. I need a cab.
You need walk no longer. There's a cab coming to you.
It just hit somebody. That is not, in fact, the cab. We will have a special Roman cab coming. It is not driven by Roman, but these cabs are hitting a lot of people. Fascinating, Captain. So the cabbie is, I missed part of this, but I believe he is now in a fist fight with the guy that he ran over. And they're both going to get hit by the Roman cab. Actually, the Roman cab can't get through because they're in the way. Trying to get in. No, damn it. Can I please get into Roman's car as a passenger like they told me to?
Sir, I need your car.
What? Oh,
you're
boy.
Stealing your cousin's car?
No!
Watch this.
Okay, well, that was my attempt to use Roman's cab service. Let's, where the hell is the autosave? I don't have an autosave that takes advantage of... Yeah, the driver's gone. The driver fled, because I... Well, I don't think this will mean I can never use the cab service again, but for thousands of years, people have treated themselves. That wasn't what I meant to do anyway. Yeah, I was gonna save myself the drive, but I guess I will have to Google later what I'll save on a slot that we, you know. And just in case this was a terrible mistake, I'll find a different slot to save. But I am going to have to read up on what if you steal Roman's cab. I'm pretty sure nothing will happen. I know there is some dialogue because off screen goofing around, like when I, before I even started the LP, I saw that the driver in this car, like, he does have dialogue with you. You can skip or you can listen to him talk. Yeah, and he complains. He hates the fact that he has to give you a drive for free. It's like, you know, I'm not even gonna make money off this fare. It's wasting my time, you jerk. Which, fair enough. But I wonder now if he will make reference to this. Hey, cousin, I'm sorry. None of my drivers will pick you up because you stole the cab from them. But because I didn't, they said press Y to enter the cab as a passenger. And then the door was locked, and probably because the car was in a position where it couldn't take off once I was on board, because it was stuck with those other guys. I don't know. All that was kind of weird. There's a lot of weird randomness about GTA 4. It's a game that has like a lot of weird things can happen with the NPCs. There's a lot of randomness in how NPCs behave. So we had a fight on the street, which we did not. Well, there's a cop car right there. Maybe I better just pay the toll. But there was. Oh, the cop actually cheated and just went through without paying the toll. Anyway. I guess we could go get started on one more mission, but I'm not feeling that great. I think I've managed to distract myself playing this game, but probably not the most productive session we've ever had, but we dealt with the entire Elizabeta drug dealing plotline. We definitely advanced the story in a major way with the whole Michelle thing, but you know, I guess I could go for some hooker action right now. None of you guys are going to be cops, are you? Anal burns. Zero tolerance on graffiti and vandalism. Okay. Well, all right, so I am going to want to check out what happens when you steal. Like, is there any penalty for stealing the cab? But, yeah, it's like, wait a second, where did the autosave end up? I couldn't manually load from the autosave, it seems like. Well, that being the case, logging on, we're not going all the way back to that, so. We don't have a lot of time left in this video. It is the last video of this session. We got like 5 minutes left. Wasted time with stuff like, you know, boating trip with Brucey. But, you know, we saw Roman, we saw Jacob, we saw Brucey all within the last video or two. Hopefully that means they'll all give us a little bit of a break about harassing us Robert Denby style. So we can at least go see what this mission is down here, because I'm curious. Setting the stage for next time, even if I'm not going to have time to do it. Oh, I already know this is I know this is nonsense, JG, because I'm not going to just pause this thing and pick it up next video. I need to be at a point where I can call it a video. So this really is a big waste of time. All right, I'll tell you what we'll do. Race, boating, bowling, drinking, eating, heli ride. Well, I haven't done the heli ride. I thought that was a special power, but I guess it's a special date that you can do with them too. Okay, he can't go on a helicopter ride with us now. It's 11 o'clock during the day. He's still asleep. Bruce, he's that awesome. Who sleep later, awesome. Oh, fuck it. Let's just get a one star wanted level again immediately. So I don't know what we're doing with ourselves here. We got 5 minutes left. I probably should just call it a video, but Brucey probably would have gone for a race, but not for, I don't even know if he races with you. Because most of these games just set up a thing where once you're introduced to street racing, it's just... There's some place where you can go trigger to activate them. Or just go to a certain spot on the map or whatever, but... I think with Brucey, you call him and he actually gets on board the car with you and goes around yelling about how alpha you both are. Yeah, we kind of do need help, if you're correct, Lee. So I guess all we'll do is we will get... We'll find out who this unknown contact is, and that will be our big teaser for next video. Perhaps it will be the mysterious Packy. There's a guy in the friends menu. His name is Packy. His like is like 0%. Which is weird, because there's more than one friend left to unlock, although one of them you don't always get. Oh, you know what we'll do? Here's what we'll do to call it a video. We will go on to the internet. See what's going on. We'll just kill a couple of minutes here at the internet cafe. Because you work here?
Because you're the best looking internet cafe girl in the whole town.
Alright. Ah, see, we got 5 emails that we can check here. Roman has emailed us about Michelle. Mostly these are from Roman. Ready to make all the cash of dreams and buy the car and house and many of the things you want. You have been pre-approved for this program. This offer is being sent to you unconditionally. We will work with you to makeeasymoney.com cash for you. The Roman Empire Wealth System. Fleece, everything at a price. Idiot-proof formula, amazing business opportunities, enormous wealth. Is this named for Roman, the Roman? Did your mom drink during pregnancy? All you need to do is sign up for our starter kit by wiring $20,000 to our offshore charity. This is tax deductible. Slave plebeian Senator Julius. Okay, so there's a whole bunch of stuff. You can read all the parodies of different scams. Greetings, Velik Nico. We have a vendor who can supply... We need a vendor who can supply. I offer $5,000 US cash just for referring us to a vendor which is liable in providing contact details of vendor required. I'll immediately pay you $5,000. Jackhammer, Mind Warper, Generation 4, Dimensional Warp Generator... Shit. Nico, shit, Michelle is working for someone. Fuck, I don't know what to say. See you later. This would be why you didn't mention it to us. You already emailed us. You set me up with the man and you set me up with the cop. Maybe you should give this make up this matchmaking, you moron. I thought I chose positive response. Listen, man, thanks for doing that. I didn't think you'd mind dating a guy after all that. Oh, listen, in the Merchant Navy, Brucey is really grateful. After all that time in the Merchant Navy, listen, Brucey is grateful you contact for us. Anyway, listen, don't be mad, but I've been having a lot of bad luck. The thing is about luck is it changes, so maybe you can bail me out, nothing crazy. They can address on here by making a minority shareholder in RBE. I'm the CEO. We're in business, cousin. Roman, how are you ever going to rule the world if you gamble every cent you get away? Miko Belek, thank you, my son. Thank you for your email. It made me cry. At least you are happy. I know you cannot live here and be well. I hope happiness finds you. Look after cousin. He is good boy. I dream of both of you settling down with nice women. It is what mother would have wanted as well. I will write soon. His mother would have wanted. Yeah, then some of the... Okay. And we can only delete that. Nice. Okay, so I was reading these out of order. Because the last one we read was... Give her a call. I know she likes you. She certainly likes finding out what we're up to. I tell you what, let's see if we can make things right with a cabbie. Aww.
You don't have to see me.
Okay, well, I guess I didn't have an answer or I messed it up. Let's try getting a Roman cab home from here now that we've stolen it the last time.
Roman is your cousin. Any chance of getting a cab?
You need walk no longer.
There's okay, apparently there is no penalty for us having stolen that cab last time. So let's, we cleared our emails. Now we know Roman will never say anything to us in, like, voice-acted dialogue about the Michelle situation, because we have an email instead. Oh, it's hold Y. I just tapped it. That's the problem.
I'm not getting paid to lug your ugly ass around, and I'm not happy about it, okay, my friend? Get in! I was thinking you would say, sick bondage club.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so he just doesn't like us.
You're a charming guy, you know that?
Screw you, shitface. You remind me of my wife, man. Mm-hmm. Take advantage of my generosity and insult me at the same time.
Got a wife?
Oh, we got interrupted.
Nico, this shit went down with those guys in Bohan. Elizabeth, I'm doing a bid. I think she might have killed Manny.
Oh, I wouldn't know about that.
You haven't been hanging around with them too much. This shit is fucked up. I'm sorry for getting you involved.
Don't worry about it. You've got enough on your plate looking after Roman. See you soon.
You're kidding me.
Sorry, cab driver who hates me. You were insulting me. I guess I missed it because I was talking to Mallory, whose phone calls have the power to interrupt any dialogue. Well, Mallory feels bad she got us connected with those people, but I mean, hey, the important thing is that it introduced us to Playboy X. And obviously, Playboy X is somebody who will be our good friend and help us with a lot of problems. So... Oh, I wonder if it costs us money to skip part of the ride in this cab, because the ride is free.
Now get out of here and don't trouble me again.
Yeah, that should be free. What? But you see? Do you see why I'm upset? So, I don't know, and this is why it's like, what's the point of trying to save cars? It might be because we rode a taxi cab here that it got wiped out, but I will have to probably see if we can find an earlier save and get that car back, or just decide it's not worth it. You can't keep fucking cars in this game. But as it happens, it's at the end of a session, and that's where I was the last time something like this came up. So now I will have to think, come Friday, if I'm settling in with a bourbon and Coke, do I replay... Do I find something from some slot and play from to get, Use your words, JG. Do I try to get our car back? Because we've probably got saves where all I would have to redo is, like, you know, oh, we lost the progress we made with Brucey on a date. I don't know. But that stuff ticks me off, man. Catch you guys next time when we may or may not have our comet back. Bye-bye.